President Trump held his first coronavirus news conference in months today as dozens of states and the District of Columbia experience a rise in infections. Now, the presser came amid a new warning from the CDC about how many Americans are actually infected. Skylar Henry reports from the White House.
President Trump shifted his tone on the coronavirus pandemic as he held his first briefing on the virus since April.
It will probably, unfortunately, get worse before it gets better.
The president's decision to resume the briefings came with the U.S. approaching nearly 4 million cases of the virus, a number the CDC warns is likely much higher. Cases are skyrocketing in California and parts of the South.
We have embers and fires, and we have big fires, and unfortunately now Florida is in a big tough position.
Unlike the early months of the pandemic, the president also encouraged Americans to take mitigation measures seriously after he was seen attending a fundraiser without a mask Monday night.
We're instead asking Americans to use masks, socially distance, and employ vigorous hygiene.
President Trump held the nearly 30-minute briefing Tuesday without any of his public health experts at his side and took only a few questions.
Why are your doctors not with you here today? Where's Dr. Fauci, Dr. Birx?
Well, Dr. Birx is right outside.
Earlier in the day, presumptive Democratic presidential nominee Joe Biden, who wants to make testing more widely available, accused the president of giving up on the American people.
You know, he's quit on you, and he's quit on this country. But this election is not just about him. It's about us.
On Capitol Hill, Trump administration officials and lawmakers continue negotiations on a phase four relief bill that's estimated to cost at least $1 trillion. Administration officials say a deal on the next stimulus bill could come by the end of the month. Skylar Henry, CBS News, the White House.
Well, President Trump says he's willing to work with China on a coronavirus vaccine if necessary and plans to hold more news conferences over the next few weeks.